From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
You're watching News 8 Now. I'm Shannon Moss.
I'm Norm Karkos. Emergency management officials will be watching the Penobscot River in Westbrook later today. All of yesterday's rain, which has continued into today, is causing flooding concerns there. The National Weather Service says that the river is expected to rise about 2.5 feet above flood stage. And in York County, the Emergency Management Agency is warning people that many local roads in York, Kittery, Elliott, and South Berwick and Lebanon are closed because of the flooding. Agency officials say crews will assess the situation today.
State Medical Examiner's Office is scheduled to perform an autopsy today on the body of a woman from New Hampshire who had been missing since December. Maine State Police say on Saturday some people found the body of 29-year-old Sarah Rogers in a wooded area in Clinton. It's about a half mile from where her car had been found at Interstate 95. Police say there are no signs of foul play, but they're going to wait for the medical examiner to determine the exact cause of death. Rogers' family had said that she has had a history of mental illness and had run off before, but had always returned a short time later. We expect to get some more information about a deadly crash that happened in Standish. When the Cumberland County Sheriff's Department holds a news conference this morning, deputies say one person died. Several other people had to be taken to the hospital after the crash on Oak Hill Road in Standish early yesterday. Authorities aren't saying much else about the crash. Deputies say they'll hold the news conference today because of the complexity of the accident.
International flights resume at the Portland Jetport today. A new service running flights to and from Yarmouth, Nova Scotia starts today. The flights are made possible through a partnership between the operator of the Yarmouth Airport and the Twin City Air Service out of Auburn. The Jetport has not offered international flights since Starlink Aviation ended its Portland to Yarmouth service last year. The new flights will run each weekday except for Wednesday. And the Board of Trustees for the University of Maine system meets in Bangor today. They'll get an update from Chancellor Dr. Richard Patnod on the system's new long-term initiative that's called to cut costs, called New Challenges, New Directions. The seven-university system was facing a $42 million shortfall over 4 years.
Jury selection set to get underway today for a man from Springvale facing sexual assault charges. Joshua Lett faces a charge of gross sexual assault with a child under the age of 14. Police say a 13-year-old girl reported the assault in June of last year. Police arrested Ouellette the following month. Jury selection set to begin at 8:30 this morning in New York County Superior Court.
Today's the deadline for major party candidates to get their names in the ballot for the primary election in June. That includes candidates who want to run for governor, state legislature, and Congress. Petitions have to be turned into the Secretary of State's office by 5 o'clock tonight. Of course, a number of people have already announced their intention to run for governor, nearly 24. And for a full list, go to the As Seen On section of our website. That, of course, WMTW.com. Meanwhile, our current governor, John Baldacci, will be kicking off the sugaring season today, tapping the maple tree outside the Blaine House. It's an annual tradition. This is video from the event last year. Look at all the snow. Yeah. Another highlight of the sugaring season comes in about 2 weeks, Maine Maple Sunday. That's when sugar houses open their doors to the public to show how syrup is made. The governor likes that event.
He does, and we do too, because we like to taste it all.
That's right. That's it for this update. I'm Norm Karkos.
And I'm Shannon Moss. Stay with us. Your forecast and sports highlights coming up in a few minutes. We'll be right back.